Hello guys, welcome back again to my channel in kunsh, and in this video tutorial we are going to create a constructors basically for the users and the messages which will be helps to store the values into the Firebase database. Okay, so guys, let's start. Okay, so guys, we are in our project. So here we are going to create the two constructor, which one of them I have created. Okay, that I will show you in the other project. That is, we are creating these two. One is the chat message, this one, and one is the user, this one. Okay, so before creating the constructor, let's know what is a constructor. A constructor has is the exactly same name of its the class name, that you can see here. The constructor, that is the users, has the same name of its class name, and it have not any return type value. So this constructor never return any value. Basically there are the two types of constructor which we are going to use here. That is, one is the default constructor and one is the parameterized constructor. So the default constructor never pass any parameters. You can see this one is a default constructor which never pass any values, and the second one is the parameterized, where some parameters and the values we will provide. Okay, and these all are the methods which will helps to get the value and set the value somewhere. Okay, so I'm going to create this two constructor. Watch it, and at the end I will tell you how exactly this works. Okay, so this one I have already created half. You can watch it in my previous videos, and now I will complete it one also and create the another one, that is the chat message. Okay, so now guys, we will see how actually this constructor helps to generate the message and the users into the Firebase. So as you can see here, I have split this screen into two parts. One is my the Firebase console, and this is the our application stack, where we have a two constructor, that is a user and the chat, which we have just created. Here you can see I have created the six variables, out of which the four are the string values, and two store the one store the integer value, and another one is a long. The three first are the first display the display name, and then the email and the connection. This connection tells this online, the user is online or the offline. Wait a minute, just I show you this. So here the user, this key has stored the display name, that is Yuvraj, its email ID, that is kunsh, and then the connection, it will show the online. Okay, so the connection we will use for this. If it is has a offline, so it will show offline also. The last person you can see. So here you can see that the Deep Kumar is now offline. Okay, and this created ad is the time when the user has been registered or the login. Okay, now this recipient ID we will use as when we have login and we are going to chat with some other user. So the other user, so or the device means the application, so as it is a recipient. Okay, so now when I move downward, so here you can see here I have created a method, that is create unique chat reference. This reference has a two email addresses. Here you can see these two email addresses are combined and create a one reference of these two user. So when I go to inside this, so here is the recipient ID and this is the sender ID. So the recipient is this one, that means the Yuvraj, and the sender is B80A, that is this one, the Deepak Pandey, that is showing this one. Okay, so we have created this string, this method for to create a unique reference, chat reference. If the reference has been not created, so it will generate, or I can say it will execute the if statement, that is it will generate the first time the reference, and after that when you you chat with them regular, so it will always execute this else statement. Then we have replaced also this email ID dot with the hyphen, because the Firebase does not support the dot. So it will read, it will sometime not read that dot. So we have replaced them from the hyphen. You can see here the anyone@gmail.com, there is a dot. So among dot we have used here hyphen. And now in down we can, you can see here I have created all the getter files, that is we can say the getter methods to get the display name, email and the time, user email, and it will return the connection of the user, that is online or the offline, and it will set the recipient ID when we sending the message to the user. Now when we are going to move to the message section, there are just simple things. I have created here three string variables and the one integer variable, where the integer variable are most important because it shows the recipient and the sender status, that is it will show you if you are a sender, so the another person which you are going to chat, that reflect as a recipient and you are reflect as a sender. Okay, so guys, that's for today in this video. and we will continue into the next lecture, and we will also learn more concept about the adapters and the helpers, which helps to generate the messages and balance the recipient and sender ID. Okay, I hope you like this video, so don't forget to subscribe and share also if you like this.